Lama Bomjon is hijacking Buddhism. He is not fulfilling the Buddhist path, but he is deleting the Buddhist path. And I had been warning about this long ago, and I had written to the Dalai Lama as well, but the thing is that we live in Kali Yuga, of the demon Kali. This is the age of demon Kali, the last age of humanity, but it's a very long age, relatively. And in this time, all religions are foretold to degrade. And Bomjon would be not able to overtake Buddhism, which is happening now in Nepal, slowly and gradually, but it is happening. He would never be able to do it if the Buddhist system had no gaps, if it was a good system, if the Buddhist rinpoches, if the Buddhist lamas had been doing what they had to do, yeah, if they were selflessly seeking the good of other sentient beings. Instead, what we see, and it's not a secret, that Buddhist rinpoches of the Tibetan lineage are very, very rich and are getting more and more rich, and they became extremely materialistic. And this fact that the Western people are very interested in Buddhism, it's also misused by them. And in Nepal, there are two Tibetan lineages, or there are more, but two very separate lineages. One is of the Tamangs and one is of the Tibetans. And there was always a certain looking down at the Tamangs. You can understand this only when you live longer in Nepal. Sorry, it's a little, yeah. Because in the beginning, when a foreigner comes to Nepal, every red-robed lama, tamang, or gurung, or Tibetan, we don't recognize them, and we don't recognize their languages and the differences in the rituals, because there are differences also, slight differences. The core is not different, but of course there are differences in how they worship and what kind of symbols they are using. And the tamang Buddhists are very often somehow connected with the ancient burn magics, the shamanism of also which comes from Tibet, or kind of jhakri dhami, it means the shamans of Nepal. Also, they are kind of connected to this, and in their perception, it's the two systems are not confronting each other. So you can be a Buddhist lama, and at the same time, you can be a shaman. But according to the Tibetan lamas, the two things, it's more complicated. The Tibetans have also their own shamanic tradition, but the classical traditional Buddhist lamas somehow don't accept the tamang shamanism for some reason. And so between the Tibetans and the Tibetan Buddhists and the tamang Buddhists, there was always some kind of gap. And it was rather like the Tibetans were obviously more literate, more the focus in Tibetan Buddhism is always on study, and in Tamang Buddhism is more on practice, on helping, healing people, I don't know what. But of course, many of them went to Tibetan monasteries and learned Tibetan, and they studied a huge amount of Tamang Lamas. And my old Tamang Lama as well. He was the student of the famous Tibetan Urgyen Tuku Rinpoche, whose four Rinpoche sons, whose sons became Rinpoches. And the White Gumpa in Kathmandu is built up by this Rinpoche clan. But still, the Tamang Lamas had felt always a kind of frustration, and you can feel it in the YouTube comments when the Tamangs always, when some Tibetan is criticizing the Tamangs or Bomjon, then they come out very quickly with the negative attacks against the Tibetans that, ha ha ha, you were always just looking at your money and your monastery and never cared about the tamangs and like so. This is also the mistake of the Buddhists themselves, the Tibetan Buddhist lineage and the higher level tamang Buddhist lamas as well, because they were not Buddha-like enough to go down at the level of the simple folk and be open mind, open to every person, not just for the rich. Yes, and then I remember when I was very sick and I went to a very high rinpoche of the Seto Gumba, because someone told me that he has some mantra, some kind of prayer for sick people. But I was never wearing good clothes because I never have money. And so just he looked at me and from immediately, a person who is visiting Western countries can recognize which Westerner is rich and which Westerner is poor. And I don't have time, he told. And I was very sick from the poisoning, and I was kind of near to death that time, and I thought it's quite inhuman from a high-level Rinpoche, who is a bodhisattva. They believe, the Tibetans, that Rinpoches are, Tulku Rinpoches are bodhisattvas, who should care about every and each and every sentient being. But let's not speak about me. It's just that once and once again I realized, and many thousand times I realized, that Tibetan Buddhist lamas, they carry a big part of responsibility for what Bomjon can do with Buddhism in Nepal, because they failed to follow the Buddha's teaching and they became like an elite, with a very, they boasting too much and they thinking too much about themselves, and they have no contact with the normal folk, with the poor people and the people who have no connections and money. So they are always very helpful for foreigners. I know some of them Germans who are very rich and who invite them to Germany and put them into Hilton and so on. But come on, why is Buddhism, why must be an elite teaching? Buddha, Gautam Buddha was here for everyone. And so Bomjon comes into this situation of degrading Buddhism, because this degradation of not just Buddhism, but all the religions had been foretold. So he comes and hijacks the rest of the sauce, the rest of the ras in Nepali, I cannot express myself, the rest of the life, the prana of the Buddhism, and takes it away. And what is the medicine for this, to stop Bomjon overtaking Buddhism, is that those Buddhists should just reconsider what are they doing all these years and if this is really Buddhism. But I'm sure no one will listen to me, because again, I'm not that rich German Westerner who is inviting this and that Rinpoche or have a special access to the Dalai Lama. Actually, I did try to contact the Dalai Lama 2-3 times through people who are working in the office of the Dalai Lama, so I did have so-called contacts. But even then I got the answer that the Dalai Lama has no time for dealing with Ram Bomjon's case, that there are so many Ram Bomjon persons. But then I realized that the Dalai Lama does have time to deal with destructors of Buddhist tradition, because he put a lot of effort into warning the public, which is very good, about the Shugden cult inside Buddhism. And thanks to the Dalai Lama's warnings, also many people realize that that is like a magic, black magician part. And so the Dalai Lama does make effort to block, to, I mean, not really block, because he doesn't use authority to block, but to warn. And as the Dalai Lama has a big authority all over the world, so any word, any sentence the Dalai Lama would just say would already change things. But the Dalai Lama not even once stood up to defend the victims of Rambomjon, which are by now, in the name of Buddhism, which are 72 people. Because only 72, more than 72, but 72 I was able to count. There are more, I heard, plus others, but 72 is what I was able to count from the news and from my own research and experience and meeting the victims.
These monks must be expelled from all monasteries without any hesitation. If they are not happy, you can tell them that the Dalai Lama himself asked that this be done, and it's very urgent.